Good evening, beloveds. A very good evening to you. Hara ya difilling station in again. Hara to halalu fukola morena. Rahu fala go difilling station in again. Let's kindly log in to hear the word of the Lord. Le ba ba ile difilling station le ba bolela gore le hoko yanu la morena la fiwa. The only word that will give us direction, the only word that will give us understanding of the times and seasons that we're in. Le ba bolela gore ba boe ko difilling station morena o ba tshwaretse lefoko. Very good evening to you, beloveds. Ratso ga kere. Ga ke solo hela le lona le phenika ya ka lehatsi. Ka dina go tsa re le mogotso. A ke ra bona sepese modima a re solo betseng kana go ire le mogo yone. The Bible says he never does anything without first revealing it to his servants. Nothing has been withheld from us concerning the times and the seasons that we are in. And God continues to give us direction and understanding of the time and seasons that we are in. Hallelujah. So let us kindly log in. Let's share with someone to come and hear the word of the Lord for themselves. A very good good evening to you, beloveds. You can also indicate to us where you're joining us from so that we may be able to know just how far the word of the Lord is reaching his people. He did say that he's going to be amplifying his voice in this season, that we may be able to know from all corners of the earth what he is doing in our time. So kindly log in and invite a friend, invite a family member, so that we can get to the word of the Lord. Today we are going to have a conversation. Ra go bua na le lona, ra go bua tsatsi jeng. So I need you to engage me, because today we are going to have a conversation. I cannot have the pioneers, the frontliners, having the same speech and the same things coming out of your mouth as the rest of the world. You are supposed to be the light for the hour. So we cannot be panicking alongside the world. We cannot be panicking alongside the world. So today we are going to have, I'm going to give you the prophetic word, and then we are going to have a bit of a conversation concerning the time and the season. Kore ke batla go tlhaloganya sente gore a mmile fokole. Halele nelo a mmela lutwa. A mmera le tlhaloganya go botlhokwa thata. You know, the one thing that I always tell people is that as a true servant of God, or as someone who truly wants to serve God and aspires to serve God to the best of their ability, as per given by Holy Spirit, the one thing that you want is for the word to actually have effect, positive effect in the lives of the people. It's not about word confirmation to see how sharp you are in the spirit realm. It's not about any of those things. That is a very immature way of seeing things. If you are a servant of God and all you want is for the word to come to pass, to prove that you can hear from God, that makes the word irrelevant in the lives of the people. The most important thing about the word of God, the prophetic word of God, is to give direction, is to give us counsel, is to help us to make decisions concerning our lives, such that we will be able to preserve not only our lives, but the lives and the legacy of our children. That is the whole reason why God gives us his word, is to preserve a remnant of a people who know him from generation to generation, that we may be able to fulfill the will of God concerning our lives, and also preserve the next coming generation in truth. That is the fundamental reason why there is prophecy. That is the fundamental reason why God gives his word ahead of time, so that we may not be caught off guard, but we may know what to do concerning the times that we find ourselves in. So it is very important for me to know that we are on the same page. It's very, very important. There's no point in the word being confirmed if the word has not helped you or assisted you in making the right adjustments in your lives that will help you to benefit from the word of the Lord. If the word of the Lord does not benefit your life, then there's no point in giving the word in the first place. So today, I really want to have a firm understanding of whether you understand the word that has been given so far. For those of you that don't know, when we commenced this ministry online, it was last year. Is it September or October? September. Yes, it's September. We officially went online September last year. And God started to give a prophetic word, very, very specific words for this nation, very, very specific words for many other key nations in this hour. And we continue to see a build up of that which the Lord has said. We continue to see things shaping up according to that which has been said by the Lord. Why? Because his word is sure. If it was my own opinion, then I would be hoping that the word will come to pass. But because it is not my word, it is the word of God himself, who has esteemed his word above himself, which means that the word of God, whether we like it or not, has to come to pass. He said, my word will never return unto me void. So the question is not on whether the word will come to pass or not. The question is, are we making the right decisions? Are we preparing according to the word that has been given? Are we praying and pressing in our alone time with God to know and to understand specific instructions tailor-made for our lives concerning the very instructions we've been given? Ever since we started giving you this word, majority of you have been sending in your dreams to confirm the word, to say that God has given you a dream. Some of you have had dreams where you saw chaos in this nation, where you saw soldiers all over the place, where you were seeing people going from one place to another, migrating from one place to another. Jalo jalo. But my question then becomes, with all of those warnings that God is giving you, he's showing you in dreams, he's speaking to you through his servants, then what are you doing to ensure that you are prepared for that which the Lord is doing? What are you doing to ensure that you are found in the right place, doing the right thing at the right time? What are you doing to make sure that you are consolidating your assets, to ensure that this reset, the changes that are taking place in this time, will not cost you or will not result in you having losses in your life, but will actually result in you actually achieving more than what you had? Because what is going to happen in this season is one of two things. It's elevation, or you are going to see a serious downfall in your life. And for all the children of God, there has to be elevation, because this is your time. This is your hour as a child of God. The Lord is saying, now the tables are flipping, and my children are the ones that are going to now be the head and not the tail. Remmogo bazalwane. Are we together so far? Amen. So I'm going to give you the prophetic word that I have for you today. It's a continuation of the word that God has been giving us. It's a continuation of the word. God continues, the plot continues to thicken. The plot continues to thicken. Yano, ke bone le nako tse dingwe ke kgobega maraponyana be ke tla ke tsena mo thapelong gore modimo a nthuse gore ke se ka kgobega marapo. When I see some of the things that the Lord has spoken about, like the Lord has touched on petrol, on fuel, that because we are going to see, even in this very nation, I strongly believe that we are going to have a discovery of oil in this nation. And God has, when Israel is concerned, he has confirmed that one for me, that there's going to be a discovery of serious oil in the nation of Israel. And that, you know, Saudi Arabia will no longer be the only place that is looked to, in Russia, for fuel, because it's one of the things that they are using as a war muscle against other nations, because they know that it is something that is highly needed by nations. And on the other side, you have those that are trying to push in for the Green Deal to be pushed in by, you know, coming up with this whole thing concerning oil shortage. Everything that you are seeing right about now has been fabricated. All of it can easily just go away like that. But God has allowed it in order to shame the enemy. God has allowed it in order for us to discover our true gifts that have been dormant for the longest time. That if we did not go through this hour, we wouldn't be pressed enough to push into our true abilities. I need you to be with me at this point in time. Ke leka go go thusa gore o se ka wa ithoboga kana go ire leng mo go yone. O se tsenwe ke boithlobogo motswana. Tsatsi jeno ke batla go bua le batswana le ba itseng Setswana ba mabapi ba e leng gore ba tla utlwa se re buang ka ga sone, le ga Setswana sa me se sa tlhapa thata letang ga te go nkinela matsogo diatleng. Ehe, ai. Gone moo le a go itse. So today I want us to really break this down to a practical manner. The Lord spoke about fuel, that fuel prices were going to go up. La belen tsaga gore Setswana sa apala. I remember very well when I gave this word. Some of you laughed about it when I was talking about it at the time, because it didn't even look like a possibility. Where the Lord even spoke about the fact that donkey carts will be reintroduced again in this hour. They'll become very common, especially in villages and towns that are not that developed. We're going to see donkey carts being reintroduced as a mode of transport for this season, because it's a season of transition. This is not something that is going to be permanent. What the Lord is going to be birthing on the other side is, it far surpasses what you call civilization at this point in time. But at the same time, it's the kind of civilization that is going to edify, and that is going to bring more, that is going to better our lives, if I may put it that way. So before we get to that, we are going to see a glitch, which is what we are going through at this point in time. And because of that, we need to make some adjustments in our lives. We need to be ready for some adjustments and not panic when these things come in our lives. There was a time I spoke about the fact that cooking using firewood is something that is going to be applicable in this season. And it's not an indication that your life is going down the drain. It is not an indication that things are falling apart and nothing is coming together for you, because that is what the enemy is going to be whispering to you. He'll be telling you that you are going down and you cannot afford this. Some of you, God has already told you to move. Some of you, God has already told you to go home. Of course, this instruction is not for everyone. There are certain people, but it's very few, that God is going to allow to remain in the cities, because there's a role they have to play in the transition or in the changes that are about to take place, especially people that are key in certain key positions that God is using in this time to change and to shift power from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light. But majority of you, God is calling you back home. God is calling you back to a place where you can hear him without worrying about some of the things that you are worrying about right about now that you cannot even afford at this point in time. Sorry. So right about now, we're at a point where there's so much that is happening to a lot of you that is indicating to you that whatever or wherever you are at that point in time, or whatever you've been doing, the season for that thing has come to an end. But some of you are refusing to let go of the old season in your life. You are holding on with everything in your power to try and hold on to something that has already passed, to something that has already been written off in the heavenlies, something that doesn't even exist anymore because God has closed the curtains on it. Therefore, his favor is not there to support it and to keep it alive. I need you to be listening to me right about now, because some of you are so frustrated. You are busy trying to make something work that is not going to work. Especially this one, I'm specifically talking about even places where we are, either where you are working or whether you are still in the city, but there's nothing that you are doing. There's nothing that is working. Am I saying that you are going to be, you know, back home forever? No. The very dream that you have, God wants to help you to understand that dream better. The very reason why you went to the city to go and achieve certain things, you had a dream when you went to the city. But when you got to the city, you were swallowed up by the city and its system. And you found yourself just being in the city and pretending to be doing what you had come to do in the city, while in actual fact, you are suffering. You can barely make enough to sustain your needs. God is saying it is time to stop living a pretentious life. It is time to allow God to take you on a journey that will result in you living the real thing that he has called you to do and to be. But for that to happen, you have to follow every instruction that is being given to you in this time. No matter how you may feel, no matter what people may say, and believe me, Satan will speak through people. That is none of your business, and that is of no consequence. Majority of you, you are stuck because ubola hela ke batho. Batho. I say this a lot, and it almost sounds like it's something that doesn't exist. But we know very well that every time when you sit down, when you really think about doing what you know is best for you at this point in time, you start thinking about people. You start thinking about what your family will think. You start thinking about what your friends are going to say. You start thinking about what your colleagues are going to say. You start thinking about everybody else except God and yourself. And the Lord is saying, it's high time you stopped that. It is high time you started to face your life as it is and listen to the counsel of Holy Spirit, who knows the end from the beginning, because this is not going to be something that is permanent. This is something that is temporal while God is getting you back on the right track. Ha ke tswara re mmogo so far, bazalwane. Some of you, God has long told you to sell your car. Right about now, you cannot even afford to put petrol in your car. You can't afford the rent and the petrol and food and everything else that you have to do at this point in time. Modimo buile ka homeschooling, something that we have completely ignored because it's something, it's a path that has never been treaded before. I'm not saying some of these things are easy. I know they're not easy. Believe me, I'm not just brushing over them and being in this la-la land of my own. I know it is not easy. Change is never easy. It is never easy. But if we are going to see the faithfulness of God in our lives, we have to be able to be flexible to the Spirit's leading and guidance at this point in time. Some of you, you cannot even afford school fees anymore for your children. And you keep praying to God to provide money for school fees. He's not going to provide that money until you listen to him for his strategy concerning your children. He's not going to provide for something that is going to help you to maintain your plans and the life that you have decided to live for you and for the rest of the world. He's not going to do that. We have been programmed to believe that if my child goes to a private school, then they stand a better chance of becoming. Listen, your child can become a president as I go private school. Am I bashing private schools? No. I'm not even, you know, advocating for government schools at this point in time, because God is resetting the system altogether. Once the system has been reset, then that is when God himself will let you know where to take your child. But right about now, there are so many things at play. There are so many things the enemy is planning that you know nothing about. And majority of them are going to come as a surprise. The same way the things that God has planned for your life, majority of them are going to be suddenly. You don't know the time or the hour. God is the one that is giving us instructions because he's the one that has peripheral view. He's the one that can see all things from all angles. And whatever decisions that he makes for us at this point in time is because he has scanned the world. He has scanned every corner of the earth. And he knows the end from the beginning and the beginning from the end. And that same God is the one that knows how much you are going to have this month, how much you are going to have 6 months from now, and what is going to determine how much you have or what you are able to do should be God and God alone. Some of you, God has already told you which assets to sell at this point in time so that they remain assets, because he knows what is about to lose value at this point in time. But you are looking at it and you are thinking to yourself, no, I can't sell this car, or I can't sell that house, or I can't sell this, or I can't. He knows. He knows what will still have value at the other side, or on the other side of the great reset. And I call it the divine reset, because the one the enemy has planned is not going to prosper in the name of Jesus. It will not prosper. The question is, are you going to be a casualty of the plans of the enemy, or are you going to be victorious in the fulfillment of that which the Lord is doing in this season of the new era? It all depends on you, beloveds. God can give us the word. God does his part, but the one thing that he has given to humanity that he can never take back from them, because God never repents of his gifts, is the freedom of choice. God can never take that away from you. He can do everything in his power according to your prayer, when you say, let your will be done in my life, that is when God can come in with his angels and frustrate your plans. And majority of you, because you have prayed that prayer, if you have prayed the prayer for God's will over your life to prevail, some of your frustrations are simply because your thoughts and your plans are not aligned with what you've prayed for. When you prayed for the will of God, now angels of destiny, you pretty much activated them in your life, and they've come to reset your life according to the will of God. So which means if there's anything in your life that is not in the perfect alignment with the will of God for your life, God is frustrating in this season until you align. So if you don't want to be in a place of frustration, you need to seek God. What exactly are you doing? Because sometimes we pray amiss. We have prayed for the will of God, but ha go ja manteng ra la gape re boela go gwene re modimo jemolla a ba re ga ke jemolle o rile ke bakanye jaanong ga bona go ja mateng bo itse gore that was not a path that I had opened for you as God. Then let it go, because there's something else that I am paving way for. There's something else that needs the space of that which had been occupied by the wrong things in your life. And so because you have prayed for my will, there are certain things that I'm going to remove in your life. There are certain things that I'm going to frustrate in your life so that you can get in the perfect alignment with my will for your life. So if you find it hard to leave the city when you are supposed to leave the city, anything and everything that keeps you in the city will have to be removed so that you don't have any reason to stay anymore. And during that time, you'll be crying. You'll be telling God how much he doesn't love you, how much he's not hearing your prayers. Majority of you, God is at work in your life. So you don't even know it. You think God has neglected you. You think God is not hearing your prayers. The day you prayed for his will to be done in your life, that day, that very day, the Spirit of God started to move in your life. So simply because you are not aware, or you are not yet attuned or in one accord and in one understanding with what God is doing in your life, you may be tempted to think that God has not answered you. You may be tempted to think because of the uncomfortable season, because we hate discomfort. Nobody likes to be uncomfortable. If there's a certain way you are used of living, when it's suddenly disrupted, nobody wants that. It's a painful thing. It's like wanting a baby, and then when you are pregnant, or when you are now, it's now time to give birth, you feel like, I'm not even sure I want this anymore, because of the pain that comes before the child is birthed. And majority of you are going through that pain right about now. Why ipotsa gore modimo o kae? Because, and here's the part that we don't get. You see, when you receive the word of God about what he's going to do in your life, there's so much gladness that comes upon you, because you are shown the end from the beginning. And then you tend to assume that you are just going to slide into the end that you saw. Keleka holu tusa bazalwane, because I know this is one of the things that make people backslide. This is one of the things that make people feel that God doesn't love them, that God has favorites, that God has this or that. No. You saw the end. When the servant of God spoke to you, you saw the end from the beginning. When God gave you that dream, you saw the end from the beginning. When God gave you that vision, you saw the end from the beginning. You saw the end from the beginning. Now, what happens between? Satan comes in to test the word. Did God really say? You see, when we talk about Satan coming in to say, did God really say? We just think about it exactly like that casual. Did God really say? We don't understand the magnitude of how far Satan goes to try and discredit the word of the Lord over your life. You will start to ask yourself on a daily basis whether you heard God correctly, whether the servant of God heard God correctly concerning your life, because everything seems to be going down the drain. Everything seems to be getting worse and worse and worse. Everything seems to be going the other direction from that which has been spoken by the Lord. And then what do? You start to confess that which you are seeing with your naked eyes. You don't continue and remain in the same confession of that which was said to you at the very beginning. Listen to me very carefully. Very, very carefully in this time. What you are currently seeing in the world, what you are currently seeing in this country, is but the beginning. I need you to listen to me very carefully. Because gone are the days where I'm going to dance around the truth. Because that is not going to help you to suit up and to get ready for what God is doing and what is unfolding in the world at this point in time. There is a war that is taking place at this point in time. There is a war. The war has always been there, but in this season, it has intensified like never before. And Satan doesn't have time out. Even when you are down, he will not say, now she's down, let me give her 2 seconds to recover and then I'll come. So unless you know where to fight from, unless you know how to fight the good fight as a child of God, unless you know how to be in your place of favor and protection as a child of God, you get to be a victim of this war that is taking place between the kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of light. So it is very important to know how to fight the good fight. I just spoke about a word that comes from the Lord concerning your life, concerning your family, concerning your nation, concerning the globe. We all know that there is a word that has gone forth concerning the plans of God for the world at this point in time, for this nation at this point in time, for your life, and it's all beautiful. Why? Because everything that he speaks is good. Everything that comes from God is very good. But at the same time, there is an adversary. There is Satan who comes in to contend against the word of the Lord, who comes in to challenge the word of the Lord over your life. Now, for the longest time, every time Satan comes to challenge the word of God over your life, you surrender. Every time he comes to challenge the word of the Lord over your life, you chicken out. Every time he comes to challenge the word of the Lord over your life, you renounce the promises of the Lord over your life. Why? Because you feel defeated. Because you lack the stamina to fight. Why? Because you don't know how to fight. Have you ever asked yourself why every single time the enemy comes to attack you? Why every single time he would give you a dream that comes to discourage you? The first thing that you do is speak a negative report over your life. Have you stopped to ask yourself, how is this fight? How does it really work? But it's not working. Fire. But it is not working. But it is not working. Have you checked your mouth? Have you checked what comes out of your mouth? Have you checked what you say every time when you see something or you hear something or you dream of something that is contrary to the report of the Lord concerning your life? The Bible lets us know exactly how the enemy works. The enemy comes to change your mind. concerning what the Lord spoke to you. The enemy comes to change your mind. I'll say it again. The enemy comes to change your mind concerning the report of the Lord for your life. So everything that you've been seeing, especially this week, this month, because the Lord was showing me that majority of you, he has come to attack you in this month. And majority of you, you have started to confess discouragement. You've started to confess the opposite of what the Lord has spoken over your life. I've said this many times. It is time to graduate from being the type of car that gets jumped. It stops moving. You come, you jump it, and then when you leave, it stops moving again. The engine dies again. And you have to come, you jump it again, the engine dies again. You are not meant to be such a car. God has called you to continuously be on fire, to continuously confess the right thing, no matter what you see with your naked eyes, until what you see with your naked eyes matches what the Lord has said. Now that, my friend, is faith. That right there is faith. You are a faith person. You live and you have become a part of a faith kingdom. This is our currency. We have no other currency. To the world, it is madness what we carry. To the world, it's madness, our currency. But it is the most powerful currency ever. But when the people that belong to that kingdom do not utilize that currency, then all other currencies of this world seem to have higher value than our currency. Why? Because they understand the power of confession. That is why they even have affirmations. Every morning, they stand in front of the mirror. They start to declare who they are. They start to declare, I am powerful. I am successful. I am beautiful. I am this. I am that. I'm a conqueror. I'm a this. I'm a that. They confess all of those things. Why? There's power in that which you speak. Because as you speak out of your mouth, your ears hear. You are more or less speaking to yourself. It goes back to you. It enters you with your ear gates. And then it takes its place in your spirit, man. And then it births itself as revelation to your brain. And then when it comes as revelation to your brain, good or bad, that is what you act upon. Because that is what you have spoken to yourself. And that is what you become. And because you don't only speak it to yourself, but you are speaking it to also to your surrounding. Because when you speak, it's waves. They go to certain places. And because creation responds to that which we speak, creation then responds to that which you are confessing. So Satan comes in to make you confess death upon your life, to make you confess failure upon your life, to make you confess the opposite of what God has spoken over your life, so that you can get creation ready to resist the word of the Lord over your life. Because you carry power at the end of the day. You have the final say in your life. God gave you the freedom of choice. He gave you the freedom of choice. And it is high time you chose to contend for your inheritance. It is high time you chose to contend for your destiny. It is high time you chose to contend for that which the Lord has spoken over your life. O tswale mathoela Satan le ha ka re wa go di bontsha tsothe tse di sa tsamaelane le se modimo a se bua o gane o re ka gana. Ke a di gana Satan. Tse ga se tsane, ke a di gana. Because now he's launched a fight like the one you have never seen this kind of fight that he has launched in this season for you. Like never before. The Bible says, not the Bible, the word of the Lord that he gave for 2021, in 2020. He said he comes vicious. But in this season, as he comes as terror, I also come as terror. And we know that the terror of the Lord, there is none like it. So if you want to see victory in your life in this season, get behind God. Get behind what God is doing. Let go of your plans, Mozalwane. It is time to let go of your plans and embrace the plans of God for your life. So what if the people will talk? Listen, in this season, I'll be very shocked at the people that have time to talk and to laugh at other people, because it's a very, very eventful season. It's a very, very busy season for every single one. So if you are somebody who always worries about what people will think, in this season, no one will care. Besides, there are so many things that are coming forth, such that for those that love to know what's happening in other people's lives, by the time they try to look at your situation, something else is popping up that side. They go to watch that, and then they hear about this one being exposed. They go there, they go there, they go there. That's another way Satan gets to frustrate humanity and gets them to squander their time when they are busy looking at other people's lives and what is happening in their lives. So that is of no consequence. It is of no consequence whatsoever. This is a golden opportunity for you as a child of God. It is a season of both extremes in both camps. So you want to make sure that you are in God's camp so that you can see the extreme encounter or the extreme abundance that God has in store for you as his child. But in the camp of the enemy, it's also going to be very, very extreme. Very, very extreme. As you have seen, everything that you have seen since COVID-19 is nothing compared to the fullness of his plan. But God wants to spare you from all of it. And he's ready to cover you in this time. Before you can follow the instructions of the Lord. Some of you, where God has told you to move, right about now you have the chance to literally pack up everything that you need. But if you wait for the last hour, wa go tswahela ka sone so sa pele, wa go tswahela o le haole like ke ra haole like wa go tswahela ka so sa pele o bo ya go tshwentse go ate. Then don't be like that. Don't be like Lot's wife who looked back when they were given an instruction to leave the city. To leave the city and not look back. But she refused. Dipone tsele tsa Sodom le Gomorrah ne di sa motsei sentle. Ha akanya go ditlogela a sa itse gore gate ba kae. But let me just gaze at them one more time. And that was the end of her. This is a very crucial time, beloveds. I don't say these things to scare you, but I am saying these things to caution you in this season, because if I don't do that, then I'm also not doing you justice. And I will not be doing my work or my job and my assignment as a servant of the Most High God. Some of you, God has told you to sell certain things because he wants to help you to clear out your debt. Some of you, God is telling you to sell certain things because he wants you to use that money to start the very thing that he's calling you to do, so that you can make enough for him to help you to pay out your debts and to also step into the fullness of that which he has for you in this season. I have a sentimental, it's of sentimental value, so I cannot let go of it. Ka hona ka sentimental value. Ga o sa irekise gompieno sone sa re mo se rekise. By the time o rua se rekisa, I was giving this example earlier, that we will literally have some people selling very expensive Mercedes-Benz for 10,000. And you will be forcing the person to buy. It is the latest this, it does this and that, and they will tell you, I don't know if I need it, if I want it. You see, that's how the rich always get richer. But God doesn't want anyone to take advantage of you in this season. So he wants you to get the fullness of the value of whatever it is, convert it. Because what you are simply doing is you are simply preserving your riches. God is asking you to convert that which you have at this point in time into something that can be preserved. And then when you convert it, he will tell you what to use it for. And because he knows what it will still have value during this hour that we are in, that is what he will tell you to convert that into. You will not, it will not even remain in a monetary value. Because money is also going to be affected in this season. The value of money is going to be affected in this season, severely affected, because the dollar has to die before it can be resurrected. So at this point in time, there are certain things, even as I speak right about now, God is putting those things in your mind. Don't think to yourself, because wa irata kana wa serata gore a ha ke utlwi go itletse hela ga se modimo o bo ta re wa go rapela khantle o rapela modimo a go arabile mozalwane o rapela modimo a go modimo go arabile o go arabile wa go araba le gompieno ntse re bua yana wa ditisa motlhaloganyo ntse wa di bona are a di tsama. And then he said, when you get that money, don't be too quick to spend it on your own plans. Pray about it and don't even lie to yourself. Be honest with yourself, because whatever it is that God is going to instruct you is good ground. Whatever it is that God is going to instruct you to do with that money is good ground to sustain you and to also get you to where God has always wanted to get you. You see, God wants to make a complete spectacle out of the plans of the enemy in this season. What God wants to do in your life, if you decide and you cooperate with him, is not even to help you to survive the season, is to elevate you to a place you have never been in your life. That is what God is doing in this season. A time of famine is a time of promotion for the children of God who hearken to the instructions of God in that time. But how can you simula o nabita ere le ha o tsa mahala motho a kopa kana motho a tla go kopa mahura kwa gago o bo re ha ma go thata malatsi a mahura ke a bohelo o palelwa ke go tsela motho mahura mo kopeng o bo re modimo o tla go ba o tla go baakanyetsa mo seasoning. You are fooling yourself. But only those that will hearken to every instruction. Kore la ha utla gore hey ya ka ba ipegile yana fuele gompieno kore bongame bo a go ya ko tops mona go yere le mo go yone ka gore ne ntse re bala diphisi tsa nama ga ke tsore gompieno go a go nna janyano modimo re a go ska nna jalo mozalwane a go ska nna jalo ha le gore le pelwa ga go gontse yalo. And sometimes it is from a place ya go batla to preserve yourself and your children. It's understandable, but that's not how we operate in this kingdom. That is not how we operate. That is why he gave them daily manna when they were going to the promised land. It was right about this time, when they left Egypt and they were going to the promised land, where God was providing them with manna. He would tell them not to keep it for the next day. He was trying to teach them. Gona le mo virgin gona le yana ka gore ga o trust modimo ga o tshepe gore modimo o ta go baakanyetsa sengwe before wa amogela o gana go thusa mabapi le wena o lebile gore o ngamelela gore
go lebagane le payday o ba dile dirupe gore dirupe di 4 re 4 molape kana ke wa ne molape dirupe di setse di le 4 ye ke a Monday ye ke a Tuesday ye ke a Wednesday ye ke a Thursday nya mozalwane a go ritse se listen revival e re kuang ka yone malatsi o therella ka yone re we can't wait for revival. Do we really know what it means when you are revived in your heart? When you are revived in your heart, you become one as children of God. Ka gona bo nna ntsala ke ngwana ke ora your blood related relatives ba le hatse. The Bible lets us know in Acts when they were filled with the fire of the Lord. When they were fired up, no go senana ko ya he dirupidi for. They would willingly give. They would willingly give. They would look asa kubiwa ali ba bona go ha gona le tlhokogoga. What do I have? What can I? Can you imagine? Right about now, God is telling you to sell things for you to benefit. But then they sold in order for everyone to have enough. In order for everyone to have enough. They sold. Even right here, amongst yourselves, there are those that are in need, but you will never know. Yet God sees you as a family. There are those of you that have enough, and there are those of you that don't have anything at this point in time. But you will never know. Why? Because we have grown cold as the church. We are indifferent to one another. I even feel my spirit getting very emotional about this because this touches the heart of God. It touches the heart of God. Listen, everything you are crying about, beloved, everything you are crying about, the minute you become a giver, the minute you carry the heart of God, the minute you allow God to move freely through you, to show humanity who he is. I can't tell you how many times, anytime God would instruct me to give someone who was not even expecting me to give them at that point in time. Even if that person didn't know God or they normally don't go to church, the first thing they will say is Jesus. Why? It's truth. So it's coming from the spirit man, because your spirit always knows truth. It knows who God is. So when something comes from God, your spirit can attest to it. They will say, Jesus, thank you. Why? They know it's him. So anytime when we give as the church, we are reflecting him. We're always crying, Lord, I want to reflect you. Give. You want to reflect and give. Oscar Simulan Uingwaba, Hamudima Buaran, Akuha instruction, and Tahor Ofe, Obeingwaba Widrogar Hamudu, Wamuka. And guess what? He wants to bless you. Because whether you like it or not, when you give, multiplication comes to you. I don't know why I'm going down this direction, but God is speaking, so I'm going to allow him to speak because he's the one who knows what we need when we need it. Right about now, majority of you are crying to him, so he's giving you answers. From the very beginning of time, God has always been a giver. He's always been a giver. The Father gave the Son gave the Spirit. And both these gifts were the best gifts that could be given to humanity. The best of the best of the best. Nothing can top them. Nothing. Giving your time, giving your resources, because even time, sometimes basadi baholo, they don't even want your money. They just want someone to listen to them. Helaba aba bolele ditori tsa bone gore bogolo golo le bone ba kile ba be ile di girl ikile abe le kharba go bolela le bile lona le na bo kharbe maletsa na ne re ba kharbe. You are giving them your precious time. Precious time. You listen to their stories. Oh, not the lebo no sari banzi akwa. Komu jolo ba roba bilu. Usa nehasi le musadi mukolo and listen to wisdom of old. Giving.
God in this time is taking us back to simplicity. You see, God has a way of getting one more things than one from one strategy. Right about now, he wants to take you back home so that you can, whether it's home, like at your parents' house or wherever the Lord wants to take you, because Moses wasn't necessarily taken back to where he came from. He was taken to a different place, but nonetheless, it was his place of meeting with the Lord. So it's not going to be the same for everyone. Wherever it is that God wants to take you, he wants to just kill the noise and give you a space where you can be authentically you and allow him to introduce you to your true self. Introducing you to your true self. Bo iphitlhela o e le gore go na le dilo tse o di rata, bangwe ga le rata dikgobe mme ga le itse ka gore ko toropong ga le dije. Wa go tlhela e le gore there are so many things that you love. Some of you love taking walks, but because you live in a cramped up place in the city, you can't take a walk. Because you work from morning to night, by the time you get there you just crash. You don't know what walking looks like. You've never taken walks except when you were a child, and he's going to reintroduce you to that, and in the process remind you of your true calling, remind you of your true assignment in simplicity. In simplicity. Ba ma lo le tsaba morlo o rekele re di Sanskrit, because some of you God is going to be taking you back to that life asa go sote. Because he wants to spend precious time with you. And some of these things, do you know that people who are really rich, these are things that they do. It's all about mindset. They make you think that it is something, isn't it fuel that helps us to get things done? Kanaja. How ya di camping tse di turang tsa di US dollar to go khuduelwa money that is enough for you to build a house. O duela madi a go ba go gotsa mollo o bo kana o lo different ba gaetso kana go wa di safari o different. Le mpolel ke se ke ithabise ditho ha go mo netane ga te go bitswe firewood ya kwa e different ya go di safari kana jang a re bue ha o le kwa o tsa di nepe o tsa di selfie o ba bontsha o ba pile le mosu hela o tshwana le wa go gae kana jang go go tswa mollo hela o tshwana wa go gae o go tabe go to go tse o go duba borotho bo gana go duba borotho rena ga o dube borotho konte o ba go duela $68,000 to be in a room o apelwa konte o rile mollo ne o go di safari a go re tsogeng kompeno batswana re le se go tsietswa ke sata a re tlhatsweng dithaloganyo tsa rona hela re le se go tsietswa ke sata tsone di-bonfire tsa lona tse o tla bo tsaya di-selfie o bo a go tsenya mo Instagram o bo ba bontsha gore o ne o ile kae kae dira bonfire e ko lape o ape o re se gore motlakase o timile ke wa gamang. It is time to wake up. And these are small things that are going to be a test for bigger things and bigger promotions that God wants to bring in your life. You see, the one thing that you need to understand about being a leader, because God in this time is scouting the world for leaders that he can use in this time. You have to be someone that can relate with people from all classes. You have to be someone that easily adapts to different situations. You have to be someone that comes up with solutions in every given situation. You cannot be a profound leader who will impact a generation if you are somebody who's restricted to certain things. I only deal with delicates. I only deal with the rich, I only deal with politicians. You are a politician, you don't even know the people that you are leading. You don't even know how many people in your community are in desperate need, that don't have food at all, that are destitute. You don't even know. You have never sat down with them to know and understand how they live and what they truly need in their society. Why? You can't lead. If that's you, you cannot lead. If what you think leadership is, or if you think leadership is all about going to a ball, going to, you know, high profile dinners, meeting so and so, humita leba humi, you cannot lead. O tshwanetse gore tsamaela gongwe le gongwe, o tsene mo bathong, o itse gore all your subjects di tshela byang. You have to know. You have to be one with your people. You have to be one with your people. Even when you command, those of you that have watched war movies, you will see that a commander that goes to war, a king that goes to war with his people, is a beloved king. Why? Because he leads his people in all things. Make me proud. He leads. And then when he gets there, he negotiates to save his people. He does everything possible to come up with a treaty with the other kingdom or with the other king to avoid going to war with the other kingdom. But you are just thinking about the life that you possibly stand to live. If God was to elevate you, then his eyes are not even on you at this point in time. This is a time of training that you are in. And this, everything that you are seeing happening at this point in time, is meant to be training in your life. It is simply training. So instead of crying, instead of feeling like it is not fair, you need to be asking Holy Spirit for strategies. You need to be asking Holy Spirit for strength. You need to be asking Holy Spirit for understanding on how to maneuver these untreaded places during your time of training. Because God knows what is required of you, where you are going. You don't know what it takes. So he has to buffen you up for where you are going. Otherwise, Satan is going to chew and spit you out. Up there, where you are believing God for, my friend, it is not for the faint-hearted. Because Satan plays dirty. Now, if you cannot afford or if you cannot handle the little games that he's playing on ground, then don't think you can handle the games that he plays up there. He doesn't play fair. He never has and he never will. So God wants to buffen you up. He wants to train you. He wants you to understand how this world operates so that you know how it operates. You know how to maneuver your way around it and you still get to live according to the kingdom of your Father. You still get to walk in the favor of God even though you are in the midst of chaos. In this world, the chaos of the world will never go away, but you don't have to be a part of it. But for you to not be a part of it, you have to learn kingdom ways. You have to learn kingdom ways. And one of the things about this kingdom that ushers you into the bountiness of this kingdom is giving, which is something that is still very, very, very hard for believers. Very, very hard. When God began my training, the one thing that he was very, very adamant on was his training me in giving. Ho hantsa mikisa ho o nsugile go suga. Go ntshuga e seng mo go nyenyana in giving. There's so much power, beloveds. La ga o ka rapela from sun up to sun down. If you are not a giver, you limit God from what he wants to do in your life. I know Satan has done so much to make giving a detestable thing. There are so many scammers out there. There are so many things that are not right out there. And like I said, listen to the leading of the Spirit on how to give. But be a giver nonetheless. Be a giver. Because as you give, it shall be given unto you. Heaven cannot withhold what belongs to you when you give. Even when you don't ask for anything, your giving speaks volumes on your behalf. Your giving speaks volumes on your behalf. And in due time, you are going to see when it starts to rain in nations. Zalipa isaria terikus. You know, the Lord was really dealing with me on this one earlier. He said, you are giving my people the fullness of my word except for one part. And I've been avoiding it because I know it's the part that Christians don't want to hear about. But he said, everything cannot be divorced from giving. We cannot divorce the ways of God from giving. It's like having everything that you need to build, and then you don't put foundation, because you cannot build without a foundation. Therefore, we can learn everything and have all the revelations from God and know how to pray in tongues and have all these things in place. But if we lack in giving, then we cannot move into the fullness of those things, because giving is what? It is the action of putting that seed on the ground to see the tree that God spoke of in your life. It is that very seed that results in the tree that you will see. When you give, and then when you pray and you do supplication with your reading of the Bible and your worship and your praising of God, that is now you watering the seed that you have put on the ground. And many of you may be tempted to get upset, to say, I don't have anything to give. You do. You do have something to give. Every single one of us, we always have something to give. We just don't know what it is. Sometimes we overlook those things. Sometimes we overlook them. The woman who had the little oil, she didn't think that she there was any way that she was going to get out of debt with what she had in her house. She probably never even thought of that oil. To her, it was just ibileya hela. Abaitzimuri. But it was gold. It was gold. It was gold. Have a different mindset today. Majority of you are discouraged because laka nya ka lehats o budget ka salary ya gago ga ka kwa tshela ka salary mo zalwane salary ya gago ga ka ke ya go tshedisa botshelo jo modimo a go bokhetletseng gore o botshele. Don't even look at your salary and think. That's why you are depressed, because you are trying to be practical the worldly way on how you are going to get out of the situation you find yourself in. The strategies lie with Holy Spirit. He knows how to multiply what you have. He knows how to get you to where you are supposed to get with what you have. So don't even look at that and think that you can find a way to maneuver your way into. And anytime we become unnolebela na go nanga methata ke yone na go shona thata le go heta. Kgwedi e o nangane ka yone ke yone kgwedi e leng gore o a go nna le bothata le go heta. Kore by the time yanong kgwedi e setse e tsamagagare go thata-thata-thata mo e leng gore ga o itse le gore o wa ga mang. But when you just o kare, and you know, giving makes you look irresponsible sometimes. Satan o kgona gore na re mmogo sentle. Wa itse gore madi a ke a seshapo sa next week o irang. Na ga ntha dilo tse kere he ya ko inketeng ha le gore ke nna childish ntogele ka bo childish jwa me e. The Lord said we must be children before him. He's our father. So I'm going to listen to him and I'm going to do what he tells me to do. Be like a child. before your Father. For he will never leave nor forsake you. But for him to work, we have to allow him. You see, when every single one of us was to, if every single one of us was to listen and do what God is telling them to do, no one would starve in this world. I'm telling you. Because when somebody prays over there for God to provide for them, God will nudge somebody else and tell them, give this person that. And then you will be tempted to hold on to it because you are thinking, Lord, I just prayed to you saying that I need 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't know that he's also nudging another person who has more than what you have to give to you. However that giving will come, whether by reason of an opportunity or whatever the case may be, he knows. And then that person is also, maybe that one doesn't, he has a company and he has higher responsibilities than you. He's asking God for millions to expand his business. God tells him, hire this person. You're going to be paying them 7,000, 8,000. You had maybe 200. Somebody else needed combo. God tells you, buy them combo. God wants to sort you out with something that is going to help you, to sustain you in all your things. But your stinginess is keeping you where you are. Because you are not hearkening to the voice of the Lord. The principles of finance, the financial principles, they are there in the Bible. They are there. I remember when God called me, one of the first things that he taught me was tithing. For me, I was taught by God. He told me, tithe. And I remember there was a time where that month I only got 100 bula for my toiletries. Because at the time he said, don't seek a job, nothing. I'm downloading in your life. So I had to just obey him and live like that. Just hope someone will do something somewhere. And that month, all that had come into my hands financially was 100 bula. Nna kana nna leng kitse ke tsere ha ke tsere 10 bula o ke be ke motsenya hela sente mo envelope, because that was my 10%, and I took it very seriously. Ke tsere 10 bula o hela ke be ke motsenya sente mo envelope, because I was honoring my God. My God knows how much I have. So for me, it wasn't about what people are going to think. It's about me and my God and the journey that he has put me on. God looks at your heart. I'm trying to help some of you who may despise what God is telling you to give, even to your neighbor. Don't despise that, because God knows what that is needed for. And when you are faithful to your God is faithful to you. The Bible talks about a woman who gave the least according to people. But she, because it was her last, the Lord counted her as the one who had given more than everybody else. Why? Because to God it is all about the heart. The heart. Somebody can give 50,000, but if the heart is not right, it may not even be received in heaven. If the heart is not right. It is about your heart. And remember, these are seeds that you are putting on the ground. We live in a world of seed time and harvest time. We cannot change that law. Even the time Jesus multiplied the bread and the fish, there had to be bread and fish to be multiplied to begin with. It's a no-brainer, beloveds. It's a no-brainer. But you need to listen to the Spirit. Because for it to carry value, for it to be received in heaven, it has to be according to what the Spirit has instructed. Not according to what you decide. Whether it's more or less, it shouldn't be according to your decision, but what the Lord has instructed you to give.
because he knows the kind of seed you need to put on ground. And in this season, I've said it, your earthly accounts are going to be meaningless. You need to have a heavenly and an active heavenly account in this season. You have to have a heavenly active account in this season. On the 7th of this month, this is what the word of the Lord says. A false messianic approach. They have been bought. They have been bought. They have been bought and sold a false messianic approach. And then the Spirit of the Lord said, Elysium, Elysium. We're going to delve into this at a later time. This has to do also with the a certain group of elites in the world that are pushing this agenda. You know, majority of national leaders are really not the they are just endorsing this thing, but they are not really part of the inner circle of this great reset. So the Lord is opening our eyes to the fullness of what is really happening underground and what is really happening behind the scenes. And like I've said before, every single one of us believes in something. So even them, everything they're doing, they strongly believe that they are doing it to preserve the earth and to preserve life. So they have to take away life that is useless to, in order to preserve humanity and life. And the Lord says they've been sold a false messianic approach by the devil. And then he gave a hint about it. He said, Elysium. And then the word of the Lord continues. He says, Beverly Hills. This is not the first time God is talking about Beverly Hills. He said, the blood of the innocent cries out in Beverly Hills. The blood of the innocent cries out. The blood, it cries out from your ground. The blood of the innocent. I've spoken about the chaos I saw coming to Beverly Hills. It's a suburban area in the United States of America. I believe it's in Los Angeles, if I'm not mistaken. It's in LA. Majority of Hollywood actors and the elites in America or in LA, they live in this place. The Lord says the blood of the innocent cries out in this place. We need to pray for those people to repent, because what I saw coming in that place, once everything breaks out, it was not pretty at all. It was not pretty at all. And then they wrote for me, the first time the Lord mentioned Beverly Hills was on the 17th of February this year. And then the Lord said, Beverly Hills, many will weep for what was. Evacuation is your only way out. They will come house to house. They will come. They will say in their hearts, now we will touch those that were said to be untouchable. Hear me, evacuate. When the Lord gave me this word, it was the same time he was giving a similar word to Pakalani and to parts of Genoff here in our country. The Lord said there will come a time when the civil unrest begins. These will be targeted places because the people will say to themselves, listen, tlala ye tang e ka khona ke morena ya no ba ba sa tsweng mo ditoropong ka gore go tla ba go sena dijo mo ditoropong. Some people, the enemy is going to use them to now make them believe that they are poor because of the rich, because of everything that we know about all the looting that has been happening in our nation of national funds. So now anyone with a nice house is going to be targeted by gangs. So this is why God in this season is giving us strict instructions for our lives, because he wants to preserve your life. And he also wants you to be able to preserve some of your assets that may be that the enemy may be targeting in this season through gangs and all sorts of things that are going to be happening in this season and in this time. So let's continue to pray for these areas. And at that time, I also spoke about that area for UB
Kale, not Kale. What's that place? What is that area for UB? What is it called? There's extension 12. There's I keep forgetting the name of that place. On your way to Riverwalk, that area as well. We need to pray for that area very, very much so. And then recently I had another dream that was similar to a dream I had, where I saw that area between, by those robots that joins CBD Phase 2 Station and G West, that area was on fire. It was on fire. So we need to pray for these places. I had had a similar vision in 2018, I believe, and the Lord gave me that vision again last week. So anytime God brings something again, it means it's only a matter of time before we start seeing it. Yes, Village, thank you very much for that. So it's only a matter of time before we see those things taking place. So we need to really, really listen to the Lord, especially people who live around those areas, to listen to the Lord on when you need to move and how you can move your assets around to see how the Lord can salvage your things in this time. And then the Lord continues to speak of the blue states in the United States of America. He says, blue states, you are mine. They're all mine. I believe God is going to be doing something. He's already started doing something. It's just that we cannot keep up with these things on a daily basis. We're just waiting for something big to happen, and then that's when we'll confirm that word. But one thing I can tell you is that things are already happening, even in this very nation. Some of you, sometimes you send us some articles to confirm some of the things that God has been talking about, including the pulling of files and bringing them to the forefront. I believe that has already begun to happen in this nation as well. So we are going to see a lot of cases being reopened. We need to pray for the judge that the Lord has spoken of, because it is not going to be an easy task that she has been given in this season at all. But she needs to know that the host of heaven is with her, as the host is with any other judge all over the world that have been earmarked to dish out the verdict of heaven concerning certain cases that the enemy had given his own ruling concerning them. And then on the 8th of this month, the Spirit of the Lord called the name of Gwen Stefani. So he didn't say anything. I don't know whether the Lord wants her to come, if that is him calling her to himself. Listen, Modimo o rata. I know sometimes we have an attitude towards celebrities. I've been guilty of that, and I had to repent for it. I really had to repent for it, because God gives me a lot of word for celebrities. And because sometimes they have a very negative way of responding to the word of the Lord, it's an area that I have not really been that excited about when the Lord brings it up. But I had to repent of that, because the other day when we saw that clip, when I was sent that clip for Cardi B, and I listened to that that voice note that she sent on Twitter, where she was talking about how she was tormented by these demons that get activated by her music. This is someone that influences so many teenagers and beyond that. And the glory and the presence of the Lord and the compassion of the Father just came upon me so much. I started literally sobbing. I was uncontrollably crying. And it wasn't me, it was the Spirit of the Lord crying for this young lady. And the Lord was saying, you don't know the length, the depth of my love for every single human being. You have no idea. Listen, God doesn't have favorites. I hate to burst your bubble, but God doesn't have favorites. Even people that you look down upon, people that you hate, people that you judge, even people that are right about now making fun of his name. He said when he died on that cross, he knew it all. He knew what they were going to do. He knew what they were going to say. But he still died for them nonetheless.
So just because you and I are saved right about now, we don't become judges. We speak the word of the Lord. We encourage them. We pray for them. And when God wants to speak a word of rebuke to prune them, we do that. But we do not judge them. And we do not begin to feel more special and holier than them and feel like they're condemned. And how dare they do what they do? The Lord says, I've died for them. I saw every single thing that every single human being has done. I still died for them. That is the length and the depth of my love for every single one of you. So that day I was humbled by the Lord concerning Cardi B. I was humbled. He kept on just pouring over and over again. And I just kept crying over and over again because the love of God and the Spirit was just releasing through me the love of God for this young lady. And he said, you don't even know how many people will be saved through her. Once she gets saved and she gives her testimony, the hundreds and thousands, because I think she has like hundreds of millions of subscribers and fans. Young people, almost a billion young people follow this woman, this young lady. And she's talking about the fact that her music, it activates demons. And she can't handle it anymore as well. So music is a very powerful thing. That is why God is also targeting a lot of people in the entertainment industry. Because that is how he's going to bring about this big revival that we've been talking about. These people are influencers whether we like it or not. The masses follow them. They listen to them. They watch them. They subscribe to everything that they do. Because it's not just about the music. Whatever they wear, they wear. Whatever they say, they say. Whatever they do, they do. Because that's what an influencer does. They follow everything these people do. So because God knows how to strategize, he knows. If I get this person, I've won 100 million souls alongside this person. The Lord has spoken about Somizi. The Lord has spoken about, just at the top of my head, the Lord has spoken about Connie Ferguson because he wants to change the shape and the image of entertainment in Africa. The Lord has spoken about Bonang Matheba. The Lord has spoken about Kuli Chana. The Lord has spoken about Zakes Bantwini. The Lord has spoken about Benson Putejo. The Lord has spoken about, I even feel his presence just coming over me so strongly. To say that, don't even think, hey, Mudimu Naki Hahambon. The Lord has spoken about Kendrick Lamar, and I was shown this video this morning that he recently released a video and he's mocking the cross. But the Lord spoke about him and he said he's the only one who will heal him. I was seeing him having the cancer of the throat. I was seeing something of that nature coming upon that young man. And the Lord said his only way out. Some of them are in serious debt. Some of them are tired of pretending, the life of pretending. And God is saying he's the only one who can get them out. So let's go ahead and help you. Modimo ga ba buile wa itse hela gore whatever that is taking place in this season, as the shakings continue, he knows that at one point they will surrender to him because they have no other place to go but to come to him and to him alone. So pray for them. Le rona ba modimo ba bua mo dipelong tsa rona. Just pray for those people that are coming to the kingdom. They are coming to the kingdom. Some of them are your way out. Some of them are your destiny connects. But God wants them to be saved first. Can you imagine people like the time I saw Somizi getting saved? That was the first time God spoke to me about him. It was 2017. It caused so much commotion. So much commotion because, you know, he came back to himself. And he was giving his testimony. And he was exposing, you know, the nature of the life that he was living of homosexuality. And it brought so much deliverance to many that were trapped in the same thing. So when God speaks about these people, and God, that's why he says all things work together for them that love the Lord. All things. All things. So sometimes when these people gain all the fame that they're gaining and they have so much following, God knows. He's waiting for the right time to get them into the kingdom so that they bring all these people with them into the kingdom of our God. So we need to step away from religion and allow God to move in this season. God is looking for individuals that have come for God's mission in this time. Mujimunali mission. He has a mission to save people, and he's looking for agents that are willing to be used by him to bring in these people so that souls can be saved. The word of the Lord continues, and he says, all magic ceases to work in this season. Power lies with my spirit. True power. True power. Did I not say witches will come to confess? And did I not say witches will come to confess? Why? Power. Magic power ceases to work. But because they are good actors, they still pretend that all is well and working. But nothing is working in the kingdom of darkness in this time. Nothing is working. Nothing is working for my enemies. What they are putting on for you is a show. Nothing is working. Soon you will see. This is the word of the Lord. Arho hedile ka masala mosi. Go hedile ka ditoisi. Go hedile ka mabotele. Go hedile ka maina a bitswang go dinageng. A re go hedile ka bolloi. Le ntheditse gore kare. A re go hedile. Now here's the thing you need to understand. In the enemy's camp, unlike you, wena hela ga ona le mathata mongwe le mongwe wa itse mozalwane. Mongwe le mongwe wa itse ga ona le seemo. Why? Because you don't know how to pretend. You put it all out there. When you are discouraged, everyone will know. When you are broke, everyone will know. When you are dumped, everyone will know. That's you. But in the enemy's camp, that's why the Lord said class A acts. You will never know until it is out in the open and there's no way of hiding it anymore. And God took me into the realm of the spirit, and he was showing me the panic that is currently happening in the enemy's camp. Because he gave a warning, a very serious warning. And because when God speaks, he gave a very strict warning last year. I remember there was a point where I was like, necromancy and witchcraft. Witchcraft ceases in this season. And then he said, necromancy is punishable by death. And then he said, tell all witches, it is not a good time to practice witchcraft. Tell all witches, it is not a good time. Why? Because kwa pancha. Witchcraft ceases to work in the season. And the Lord says, soon you will see it. Because now they're just pretending that things are still together, but they're not. Even up there with the titans, he spoke about a clash of the titans. What you are seeing happening right about now, I believe, was it yesterday or today, Elon Musk issued out a statement saying people shouldn't be shocked if he dies of mysteriously, something of that nature. They're fighting up there because there's a lack of trust because of what is happening. Things are not working as smoothly as they used to. So there's panic, but they're not going to show you that panic. When they come before you, they smile, they laugh, they make it seem like everything is still together. So we need to pray for witches in this season. I know it sounds strange when I say that. I know it sounds strange. This is not something that you usually hear in the church. But I'm genuinely speaking the heart of God. We need to pray for witches in this season. We need to pray for them. Because the magic ceases to work, and they're going to be so frustrated. Some of them will want to commit suicide because they don't know what life is going to be like when their magic doesn't work. Ha go sa tlhola go phetsa ga gore mo ipotsa gore ga ke sa tlhola ya nng ke gona go tshepa into destiny ya ga Susan ke wa gama. Susan ga a lwe ge malatsia go mo ne ke tlhola ke go motshasa mo le ke itse re hela ke go motshasetse madi a tshwantse go a go ena a tsena go gonne ga go sa bereka ke wa gama. Ha lo rena tloetse gore o benefit through this one and this one and that one, now it ceases to work. Their destinies have now been sealed and protected by the Lord. Then there's panic. I've told you many times, never be scared of witchcraft. Never be scared of witches. Because you have to know who you are in Christ. They need help. They need God. They need to know that there is a higher power that they can subscribe to. They need to know that they don't have to steal your light in order for them to live a life that is bright. They need to know that their own light is there, that has been given by God to them, that belongs to them, and that can shine as bright as what they've imagined and beyond. Witchcraft is by reason of lack of knowledge. It's that simple. Witchcraft is by reason of lack of knowledge. When someone has been told by the devil, convinced by the devil, that the only way you can make it is if you give me the destiny. Because what happens is that their destinies are not even, they don't even benefit from your destiny. They simply open a window for the enemy to have access into both their lives and yours. And then what they're getting from the enemy is peanuts, and it's also magic. It's not real. It's not real wealth. That is why it's going to vanish in this season. It's magic. It's going to vanish in this season. They're not real wealth. It's not real wealth, beloveds. They've been duped by the enemy. They've been deceived by the enemy. So that Satan can have access into their lives, their light, their true wealth, and yours by reason of contact. But all of that has ceased in this season. Why? Because God said it is his time. It is his time. It is that simple. He has power to stop them anytime he wants. He has the power to shut it down anytime he wants. And in this season, he has shut it down. It has been emptied out. So I don't run on to attempt the Haruba Nagarva, the Rekahakahur, Ulikeka. Don't even bother yourself. You are in the right place. And soon they will see that in your life and they will come. I've seen witches coming to the house of God in this season. I've seen them come. I've seen witch doctors come. Serious witch doctors come. What manner of power is this one? What manner of power is this one? Because they're not shy to talk about this. There are people who deal with power, with the spirit realm, authority and power in high places. There are people who are acquainted with the spirit realm, but they have never been to the highest of places where we are seated with Jesus. Or where you are supposed to be seated with Jesus, which is above all principalities and powers where they operate. So they are used to power, but not this kind of power. So they will come because they understand for you to stay on top, for you to stay dominant, you have to be at the highest of places to subdue all other powers. That's why I don't know about that. I don't know about that. I don't know about that. There's rank. But all of these things, if you want to, how sa batlo go nna ntse o rally di rank in this level of witchcraft and satanism and all of this nonsense, you simply have to go to the highest of places and settle the matter. And that is where Christ Jesus is seated with his Father and with his bride. And you get to be part of the bride. And then you can look down and call on your brother or your sister who is into witchcraft, who is into satanism, and say, yo, come up here. Come, let me show you a place where you and I don't even have to compete for anything. There's abundance. You can shine and I can shine and everyone can shine and become what they're supposed to become. But ha, kisin piti ke kuhite. Oho satan kisin piti ke kuhite. And God in this season, he says, magic ceases to work. You're going to be shocked in this season. Some people that were seemingly rich are going to suddenly wake up with nothing. Because it was never true wealth. It was magic. I need to stress that point so that you also get to help them to understand. You were not in his will and now he's placing you in his will. So don't even be too quick to call people witches when you see certain things happening in their lives. Because it could just be God putting them where they're supposed to be and getting rid of certain things in their lives that are not supposed to be there. And like I've said, for me, witchcraft is like any other sin. It's a sin that needs to be dealt with. It's a sin of someone who doesn't know God that needs to get to know God. It's that simple. So let's pray about that one and let's pray for them to not be swallowed up with everything that is going to be lost in this season that was by reason of magic. May their lives be spared and may they come to the God that will give them true wealth that will last from generation to generation even after they leave this planet, because that is what God gives. Modimo ga go nele masala mos ga go nele so se leng gore ka moso se teng ka moso ga se. God doesn't give magic. God gives tangible things that live on, that have continuity, that are going to be there even after you have left this place. Hallelujah. Hela, mudimo na ekele mile kabalu. Oh yes, this was just confirmation of the words that he has given in the past. Let me not go through that one. Let's continue to pray for them. And then the Lord continues to say Accra. I've given a word concerning Accra that the Lord said we need to pray against a coup that has been planned against the nation of Ghana. We need to pray for the safety of the president of Ghana. I strongly believe that man is one of the five. He's one of the five. I strongly believe that. The Lord said we need to pray for his preservation. We need to pray for the coup that has been planned in Accra to not be done in the name of Jesus Christ. It will not prosper. It will fail. It will be an epic fail in the name of Jesus. May all the plans of the enemy concerning Accra be frustrated in the name of Jesus Christ. And then the word of the Lord continues. He says, Pennsylvania, this was on the 9th of this month. He said, Pennsylvania, bloody affair. Pennsylvania, bloody affair. It's about to get very, very intense in the United States of America, and we need to pray. God began to speak to me about Pennsylvania in 2020, and he made it clear that Pennsylvania is going to be the place of the shift, that is going to be the place of whatever that is going to take place in Pennsylvania is going to be a clear indicator of what the turning point of America from the grips of the enemy to the freedom that God wants to bring into America. But it's going to be a bloody affair. So we need to pray for that. I remember when he gave me this word the first time, he made me
research about Gettysburg, the war that happened in Gettysburg. So we need to pray for this place. They retrieved a word that was exactly the same that God gave on the 7th of December 2021, where he said Pennsylvania bloody affair. The same word he gave this month on the 9th, he said Pennsylvania bloody affair. And anytime God repeats a word, word for word, it means it is only a matter of time before we see that happening. The other words that he had given, just to give you a recap on Pennsylvania, on the 26th of, on, no, it was June 2020, he said, Pennsylvania, my eyes are on you. A siege is coming to America. Pennsylvania, key zone. Pennsylvania, you have reached a boiling point. Pennsylvania, look unto me and see my move. Pennsylvania, my eyes are on you. And then on the December 2020, he said, Pennsylvania, shift, significant shift. My hand becomes evident to every eye. Where my hand lies becomes evident. Time to vindicate my servants. Mockers are about to be mocked. For my timing is right, and my timing is now. Pennsylvania, macro engagements. Now, when the Lord said mockers are about to be mocked, the word that God has given in this season, especially when he started to release it in 2020, the opposite of what the Lord said happened first. What pretty much happened is that the Lord allowed Satan to have his way first, and then the word of the Lord seemingly looked like it didn't come to pass. So God is saying in this season, because now he has taken over from the enemy, you're about to see a rolling out of his word. Even the word that we have been insulted over as the servants of God, we've been mocked over, we've been told that we didn't hear God, and this, you've already started to see that this year, the word of God has just been, we've been seeing hints. Because what we have seen so far are just hints. We have not started to see the fullness of the unfolding of the word of the Lord, the confirmation of the word of the Lord, because there's a lot that the Lord has spoken. And some of those things are going to take place throughout the years, especially in this decade that we're in. There's so much packed in this decade. Even the plans that God has for this nation, we're going to see the shakings now, but in terms of the plans and the unfolding of the plans of God, it is going to expand into the other years. It's going to go into 2023, 24, 25, 26, and so on and so forth. But you're going to see the unfolding of the plans of the Lord in this season. And the word of the Lord continues, and he says, Hunter's gold. My scribe is talking about the beverage, Hunter's gold. But God was talking about Biden's son, Hunter. The Lord said, Hunter's gold shall be found out. Hunter's gold shall be found out. All of it shall be found out. All of it. All of it, it shall be found out. And there is a former president that is going to be found out who is linked to Hunter's gold. There are so many people that are linked to his gold that is going to unfold and is going to bring about a lot of things that are going to be shocking to many, to know the fullness of the depth of the corruption that this young man is part of. So be on the lookout for that as well. And then the Lord said, SADC, SADC, SADC. And then he said, Hava, Hava, oil, peace. The Lord has given a word concerning SADC in the past, and I've given it many, many times, where the Lord said, SADC countries are going to need each other now more than ever before. And on the 11th of this month, he said it again. He said, SADC, SADC, Hava, cover, oil. And when he said oil and then he said peace, immediately the Holy Spirit started to deal with me concerning oil discovery that is going to help to cushion the situation in SADC countries. So we need to be very, very prayerful in this season. We need to be very, very prayerful. Anytime God talks about certain partnerships concerning certain nations, we need to take that very, very seriously, because he knows what we are going to need and how we are going to be of help to one another as nations or as neighboring nations. I've spoken about the word of the Lord concerning Zambia and Botswana, and he's been talking to me about that again recently. And he said it's time for that word, that prophetic word, to be established in both nations, for the waves of that word to register to the two nations, a preservative and a conservative plan that God has for Zambia and Botswana. And he said that partnership is going to be very, very vital. And then the Lord in this time, he's also talking about SADC countries, to say that there is going to be a connection between the SADC nations concerning oil that is going to also help to bring about the peace that will be needed, which means that things will not be peaceful for a season. And one of the things that will put things to rest is this oil that God is talking about within the SADC region. So we need to pray for SADC countries to hear the word of the Lord. We need to pray for the right leaders to be in place so that the plans of God will not be frustrated for his people, so that there may be preservation of life in this very time as per desired by the Lord for his people. And then the word of the Lord continues. He says, little ones, you do not know nor understand my word. My word is alive. My word creates. When I was getting this word from the Lord, I had chills. I was taken into the depth of the secret place of the Most High. And I just saw the word. I can't describe to you what I saw and the tangibility and the potential that lies in the word of the Lord. The value that is endless, the limitless value, the limitless possibilities of what can be created through the word of God is indeed mind-blowing. He said, my word changes situations. My word is a weapon. I said this at the beginning of this live broadcast. I said, child of God, your weapon lies with your mouth. Your weapon lies with what comes out of your mouth. This season, refuse to say anything that is contrary to the word of God concerning your life. Refuse to say anything that is contrary to the report of the Lord. He says, you don't know my word. The reason why you keep confessing other things, the reason why every time Satan comes to tell you something, you believe it, is because you don't really know the potential or what my word can do. You don't really know the power of my word, the ability of my word. You think it's just like any other word that you can write yourself, or any other word that you have seen or written or read. But my word is different from any other word. My word is life. My word is power. My word is creative. My word can shift the shape of your life. My word can literally usher you into a whole new life. Just the word of God. His word. What is God saying concerning your life? What is it that he's saying that you are downplaying, that you are not confessing, that you are not speaking into existence, that you are suffocating in the inside of you? Some of you are even afraid of saying who you are, even when you are alone, who God says you are. You are afraid of just saying it. Just saying the promises of God over your life. Because deep down you don't believe what the word says concerning you. You are looking at your own ability. You are looking at yourself. You are looking at your surroundings. You are looking at your past experiences. And you refuse to speak the word of the Lord. You refuse to allow the word to come out. You are partnering with Satan
to muzzle the voice of the Spirit from speaking life into your life. And God says, in this season, you will experience the power of His word. When I asked Him last year, Lord, what is it going to take for us to step into your favor in this season? What is going to help us against all the persecution? What is going to help us against everything the enemy has designed and everything he has planned to do against us as believers? He said, everything lies with my word. My word is the answer. Kasatana atabua, something opposite to what I said. Speak my word. If at your workplace they speak a different report from what the Lord has said and the instructions the Lord has given you, what did the word say? The word of God. Because even His instructions are His word. The word. What did God say to you? Sometimes the word is difficult, but the word carries life. The word is solution. There's no other solution in this season, beloveds. Everything you hear me come here to tell you that the Lord is saying, that is the solution. There's no other. So maybe God will have a different report. No. The word. So with every single situation you face, then go to the word. Both the prophetic word and the written word, go to the word, find out what you're supposed to do, do what the word says. Don't look at the circumstance. The problem is we look at the circumstances and then they dictate what we do. We don't allow the word of God to dictate what we do. We allow circumstances created by Satan to dictate what we do, to determine our response, to determine our decisions. But the word of God is power. The word of God is power. The word is a life. The word is a person. That's what you need to understand. The problem is you think it's just something that you say and then because you can't see it. The Bible tells us that the kingdom of God is in us. As it is in heaven, so shall it be on earth. It starts where? In your belly. The Bible also lets us know that when we receive it, Jesus spoke about fountains of water, life-giving water that springs forth from your belly so that you never thirst again. What is that bubbling forth? The word of God. The Spirit of God in you propels you to speak the word that carries life and power and transforming power. And what is that word? The Bible also says He comes to testify of the Son of God. The Bible also says that He is the Word. So when you speak the word of the Lord concerning your life, you are releasing Jesus through your mouth. You are releasing the one in whom all things have been created. When He went back, He said, I don't leave you orphans. I leave you with the helper, the promise, who carries or who comes to testify of me so that I can dwell with you, all of you, anywhere you are, everywhere you are. Jesus multiplied. And we know that when He was on planet Earth, when He had not yet multiplied Himself, every word He would speak would come to pass. Why? He's the Word. And He said, now I'm going to speak through you. So anytime you release the Word of God, you are releasing Jesus. You are releasing the Word of life. And that Word comes to create in your life. It comes to touch every dead place in your life and bring about life. Why? It is resurrection itself. So don't speak the word of God by saying, it's not working for me. Speak the word. It is living. Speak that word until you see it. Be stubborn. This season, be stubborn. Be stubborn.
Be jealous for your life. Be jealous for your future. Be jealous for the life that God has ordained for you to live. Content for that life in this season. Lesa go nna o letswa ke satane mo zalwane. Ha go tewane. Hela ha ka go nela toro ka moso o pole po. Ha se mama ga ka go roga ko tiro o le po. Khaba sa go duela madi othe o le po. Be jealous. Look at that situation and say, this is not what the word is saying. O lebele go kole o. O lebe yana o bo leba situation. O leba le go o leba situation. This is a dead thing. This one is a dead thing. You will become alive. For the word of the Lord concerning you says 1, 2, 3. I don't know where you came from, you dead thing. But this is what the word of the Lord has to say concerning my life. But as long as you don't speak the word, causa khotimolo matimona nna anna hela batsala ba tshelela go o bona o shushubetse in your own space. O kila bana motho a shushubetse mo mmeleng wa gago, o shushubale mo ntung ya gago, o shushubale le mo mmeleng wa gago. Aw mozalwane, o tla go tshwenwa ke dilo tse di sa tshileng. And yet you have dunamis power. You have a weapon like no other in your belly. Hai khaka, it's in the inside of you. You've been given a mouth to release it so that it can start to put things in order in your life. Be jealous over your life. Be jealous over what the Lord has for you in this season. Listen to what the Lord said. I don't know how I missed this part. Where is it? Am I reading from the right place? Hallelujah. Modimo batla go baka loud. They didn't transfer it to this side. The Lord spoke about something very important. Just give me 5 minutes of your time, then I'll let you. The same time he gave this word, I didn't write it down. The same time he gave this word, this month, the 11th, on the 11th, he said birthright, birthright, birthright inheritance. I almost forgot another very important warning word. Thank you, Holy Spirit. This is a season. I've said this many, many times, even on the 31st, when I gave the prophetic word for this year. You see, some of the places you are refusing to go, God knows these are your places where your inheritance will not be withheld from you any longer by the kingdom of darkness. There's a place where your inheritance is going to unfold and no one will hold it down anymore. And God in this time is calling us to our places of encounter so that we may come into our birthright inheritance. God spoke about inheritance in this season. He said, some of you have inheritance you know nothing about. You have inheritance you know nothing about, but because God knows, nothing is hidden from him. You are going to come into these places if you allow Holy Spirit to guide your steps to those places where your treasure lies, where your inheritance is. Some of you are confused. You are seduced by lights in urban areas, and you are choosing those lights in place of your true inheritance, in places that are seemingly not as lit as where you are, but they carry your inheritance. They carry your treasure. You see, treasure is always hidden. Treasure is never just put on a silver platter where everyone can see it. Treasure is always hidden. And Holy Spirit comes to guide you to the secret place. How can you work a secret place? Listen, when you pray, I need to teach you some things. When you pray, there is a place where when Holy Spirit takes over, he starts to take you into what we call the secret place. When you enter the secret place in the spirit realm, You are entering your places of encounter and you are accessing your treasure in the physical realm. And it's only a matter of time before you access that treasure in the physical as you have accessed it in the spirit realm. That is why praying in the spirit is very important. Because when you allow Holy Spirit to pray, He takes you to where your treasure is. And when He has taken you to where your treasure is in the spirit realm, then nothing can be withheld from you in the physical. That is why when witches come to bewitch you, what do? They shift things in the spirit realm. They basically just hide your treasure. Or they take you in a different direction. Listen, is to get you to think your success is going to come from a certain place where there's nothing for you. And then when Holy Spirit comes in, He starts to redirect you to where your treasure truly is, which is the opposite of where you were going before. That is what He does. And in this season, those very places you are dragging to go, you don't even want to go there. You don't even want to hear anything about it. You are rolling your eyes. The things you are crying about in the nighttime, Holy Spirit is trying to take you there. He is trying to answer your prayers. But because you are not listening to Him, you are looking at things with your naked eyes. And you think where you are going is where the treasure is. That is not where it is. And God says it is time for you to come into the fullness of your birthright inheritance. Your birthright inheritance. I was seeing some people, some of you who don't even know your parents, your fathers, especially fathers. I was seeing a restoration of the relationship between fathers and their children. And God is not going to only be restoring relationships, but He's also going to be restoring certain relationships in order to open up and to give children their inheritance. Some of you, your parents will not even give you anything tangible, but there is a restoration that has to take place in order for them to release what they have been entrusted with in the inside of them into your life, so that wherever the tangible treasure is, now you can access it in your life. So God wants to restore. That's why some of you, meant things. Allow God to do what only God can do in your life. Some things and some places and some people, they carry a key. They carry a puzzle, a piece of the puzzle to the fullness of the unfolding of your inheritance. So you need to be wise in this season. And the only way to be wise is to hearken to Holy Spirit and follow and obey. The last thing I'm going to mention, the Lord spoke about borders. Listen to this very, very carefully. It's very important. And then I'm going to give you the rest of your evening. Oh, yes. I don't know. Some of you may know this show. He just said it out of nowhere. He was talking about some very important things concerning the nations. And then suddenly, this is still on the 11th of this month. He said the bachelor. I don't know if some of you know this. Is it a TV show? Is it a series? Is it a reality show? I think it's a reality show. He says, The Bachelor sickens me. So I don't know whether he knows that there are some people who watch it. So he wants them to know that he despises that show. He doesn't like it. He doesn't like what it represents. And so you should stop watching that if you are watching that. The Lord does not take pleasure in that show at all. The Bachelor. That's what he said. And then another important thing that he mentioned that he's been saying for the longest time with me, Epsom salt. Well, maybe it's going to ring a bell for some of you. I believe that is going to be one of the things that are going to be essentially needed in this season. With everything that is going to be happening, with shortages of medicine and all of these things, medical supplies and all of these things. So you can go look it up and see the benefits of Epsom salt. The Lord just mentioned it. So if he speaks more and gives you more instructions concerning that salt, whether to store it up or whether to do whatever it is, do that. For those that are in the medical field, listen to the Lord concerning that and pray about it. Allow him to speak more concerning that salt. He said it many, many times, and he said it again this week, Epsom salt. And then the Lord mentioned another flower yet again. It's called dahlia. Dahlia. Go and research about that one as well. Those of you that know how to spell that, kindly put it up for others to see. Dahlia. I don't know if we have those flowers in our country. Medical practitioners, please go and research about these things. Find out how we are supposed to use them in such a way that they will not be harmful to the body, the right usage, the right dosage, and all of these things that we can find out. The team this side, they're also on it, they're researching. I advise every medical practitioner all over the country to do their part where this is concerned, because you are going to be needed and you are going to be a solution in a time of desperation when we need alternative ways to help the people in this season. Dahlia. And then the Lord said, it's time to know the real Zelensky. It is time to know the real Zelensky. So I believe that a lot is going to be coming out concerning this man, Zelensky, in this time. Remember the Lord last time he said class A acts. Now he say it is time to know him for who he truly is. So let's keep praying for the nation of Ukraine. Let's keep praying for our nations as well. And then the Lord continues to say border crisis in the U.S., border crisis in the United States of America. Border crisis becomes worse before it becomes better. The Lord said it is going to get worse before it gets better. So we need to pray for the United States concerning this. And then he broadened up the word concerning borders, and then he took it globally. I was even seeing in this very nation, he said, my people, those that live next to the border, they need to move. They need to move. He continued to say, border lines are not safe at this point in time. Border lines are not safe. My people shall move. They shall move from along the border in this time. So when I was getting this word from the Lord, he reminded me of the word that he gave concerning land and concerning border lines, to say that by the time this shaking is over, the border lines would have changed for many nations. For many countries, the border lines are going to change, and God is going to be responsible for those changes. As history is brought to the forefront and certain things are corrected in history, and certain things that are going to be happening that will cause certain nations to come together as one, is going to be one of the factors that are going to affect border lines. So there's going to be a lot of activity, even during the shakings. People usually migrate from one nation to another, running away from whether it's civil unrest or whatever the case may be, when things get really, really tough, or when the enemy really starts to strike hard. We're going to see a lot of activities along the borders. So God is cautioning people that live very close to borderlines and borders to say that at his calling, when he warns you, when he tells you it's time to move, please do that, because God is literally going to be saving you from a lot that is going to be happening at that time. So that is what the Lord is saying concerning that. So that brings us to the end of the word today. I do hope that you have learned something. I hope God has answered you in certain areas where you had questions. And I pray that you gain enough strength to follow through in the instructions of the Lord for the hour. I know they're not easy, beloveds. I know they're not easy. But God is with you. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Whatever I am instructing you to do in this time, It is for your own good. It is for your own preservation. It is for you and your family. It is for the elevation I have promised you. Just trust me, and you will see that which I showed you in the beginning, you will see it in the end. God bless you and God keep you for the rest of the night.